collides and flashing across the sky. Like a swiftest arrow whizzing from a bow. Like a mighty cannonball he seems to fly. You'll hear about him everywhere you go. The time will come when everyone will know the name of Canyon, the wonder.
I guess not. Say, you're Les Parker, aren't you? Living with the Baxters?
Yeah, that's where I've been living.
Well, I'm Ricky North.
Yeah, I know.
Now, don't be scared. He was protecting me. But it's all right now. Now, say howdy to him, champ. There. You see? What were you throwing that rock at?
A rabbit.
How I saw him. I throw at them, too, when they get in our vegetable patch, but I never hit one yet.
I wasn't doing it to chase them. I was trying to get me something to eat.
Oh, you like rabbit?
It ain't a question of liking. I ain't had nothing to eat since yesterday morning.
You haven't?
Been out there in the hill since then.
Gee willikers. All night?
It wasn't so bad. I ran away from the Baxters.
You did? Well, why?
I guess you know my pa's in prison. Well, I took all I could stand having them reminding me about it all the time and saying I'd wind up the same way. Guess I'll mosey along.
Wait, Les. How about coming home with me?
What for?
Well, it's almost time for dinner, and
I can get my own food. Anyway, your uncle would boot me right off the ranch.
Well, not Uncle Sandy. He's the best there is.
Well...
Aw, come on.
Well, okay.
Swell. See you tomorrow, champ. You can go back to your herd. Come on, Les.
Like another glass of milk, Les?
I've had enough. Thanks.
Well, there's plenty more here if you want it. I better get back to work. Ricky, take care of the dishes, will you?
Sure, Sandy. Didn't I tell you he's the best there is?
You sure been all right so far.
Excuse me a minute, Les. Something I forgot. Don't you feel sorry for Les, Uncle Sandy?
Yeah, he's had a pretty rough time.
But he's all right, no matter what they say about him.
Well, it'll take time to tell.
You mean, you think he'll turn out to be like his father? The way the Baxters told him?
No, not necessarily. But if people insist on giving him a bad name, he might be prodded into it.
And that's what I'm worried about. Why can't he stay with us a while?
He might not want to.
Well, I think he would. Anyway, can I ask him?
Don't see why not.
Gee, thanks, Uncle Sandy. Chores around the ranch.
Say, how about you staying here and helping me with mine?
Listen, Ricky, if you're feeling sorry for me, forget it. I don't need anybody's charity.
But who said anything about charity?
Uncle Sandy believes in every man earning his own keep. Even me. I work for what I get.
Sure, just like you already started with the dishes. Come on, let's finish them up.
Sure. But when we get the new ones, they'll improve the herd. And our ranch will be one of the best in the state. That's why Uncle Sandy's drawing the $5,000 out of the bank.
$5,000?
Yeah.
Ready?
All set.
Anything you want us to bring you from town, Les?
Nothing that I can think of. Thanks.
Say, wait a minute. Where's Zevil?
I think he went out to see Champion. I'll look around for him.
All right.
You know, it wasn't very wise of you, Ricky, to tell Les about our getting that money.
Wasn't? But you trust Les, don't you, Uncle Sandy?
Yeah, but it's a good policy to keep a tight lip where money is concerned with anybody.
I'll remember that.
Your advice, I'll ask for it. Kid of yours happens to be on the ranch, you can rustle us up some grub, and grub's just what we need.
Pa!
Les, you're sure looking fine. This is, Duke.
Howdy, boy. Your dad and me heard you was here. We figured we'd drop by for a visit.
But, Pa, you get parole?
Parole? Yeah, I guess I sort of paroled him just like I paroled myself. Even if he did want to serve his time. Enough questions, old boy. Tell me, you alone around here?
Yeah.
Good. In that case, you can fix us some grub, huh? Well, go on, boy. Move.
Sure use these.
Any money around the place, boy? Anything else worth taking?
Ain't nothing you'd want.
I think you're lying.
Leave him alone, Duke. Where's the fella who owns this spread, this Sandy North?
Went to see Mr. Jessup.
Jessup? Ain't that the name we seen in the bank window, Jessup?
It's another Jessup, the horse doctor, to get some liniment. He and his nephew, Ricky.
They're riding, I suppose.
In a buckboard.
Frank, I figure it's time for us to mosey.
I wouldn't try anything if I were you. Mr. North shoots mighty straight.
Well, boy, I shoot pretty straight myself, and I make a habit of shooting first.
Don't you worry, though.
Nothing's gonna happen. I figure daytime holdups are too risky. Come on.
Thank you.
kid in a buckboard. That must be them. There won't be nothing to it.
You getting shot? All the money in the world isn't worth that, Ricky.
All right, let's have a look, see what's in that bag. Hurry up. Yeah. Some horse liniment, huh, Frank?
Camp before they get shot, and you wait here. Open that shed door. Ricky, take the money up to the house and put it in the safe.
Come on, Les.
Ricky? These two Ranahans will be safe in the shed. I'm going in town to get the sheriff.
All right. We'll keep an eye on them.
They can't get out. Besides, you've got Rebel. Thanks again, Les. Go ahead, move you two in there.
You in jail and taking a chance on your squealing.
And when I saw you up there on those rocks, gee, I almost didn't believe my eyes. I just couldn't let your uncle lose that money. Sure took a lot of gumption to do what you did, Bess. Well, what's the matter? Don't you feel good? All that running, I guess. But I'll be all right. Good. Just wait till I tell the kids at school. And the Baxters, just as soon forget it. Sure's something wrong with you, Les. Time to water the stock, and it's my turn. I'll do it. You rest up a while. Come on, Rebel. Paul?
Yeah?
I'm sorry, right sorry for the fix you're in. But I just had to do what I did.
That's all right, son.
It ain't all right.
Listen, boy. You know what's gonna happen to your dad now? He's going back to prison for the rest of his life.
No!
Yeah. Most of the time he'll be in solitary with nothing but bread and water to live on. He won't last long, you can bet on that.
And you'll have a hand in the blame.
No, don't say that!
Now listen, boy, listen close. You want your dad to live, you better cut us loose. Let us out of here right away. If you do, I promise we'll never come back.
That's right, son.
Will you promise to leave right away?
Sure, I promise. Just cut us loose.
Ah, good boy. As soon as you get us cut loose, we'll hightail it out of here. Hurry up, boy. This is not gonna be. Come on. Yeah, that's better. Now, where's that safe?
But you promised that...
I don't care what I promise. You show me that safe or your dad's gonna get hurt real bad.
All right. I'd better make sure Ricky and the dog ain't in there.
Open it, son. Open it, I'll break it down.
Let's try the front door.
From your description, Sandy, there's no doubt about it. Frank's the boy's father. He and Duke broke prison a week ago.
But that doesn't prove that Les let them out and opened up the safe.
The door bar couldn't be touched from inside the shed, Ricky. What's more, he knew where the key to the safe was hidden.
But why would he do such a thing after saving the money?
That's what puzzles me, Ricky. I just can't understand. Well, blood's thicker than water. Could be Frank talked the boy into it.
No, sir. There's got to be a different reason. There's just got to be.
Ricky sure sticks by his friends, Sandy.
Yeah, he sure does.
Well, how about mounting up and coming on the posse with me? We got to find them buzzards.
Be right with you, Sheriff.
Les wouldn't do a thing like that. Not unless he had a good reason. I wonder where they could have gone. Tracks, Rebel. They must have left tracks. Come on.
Thank you.
Cribble, your tracks. We'll get champion horses. Come on.
I'll be all right, son. Don't you worry about me.
I'm glad, Dad. I buried her. To get hurt and couldn't let Duke get his hands on the money. So I grabbed the satchel and ran for it. But Duke spotted me and, well, you know the rest. So you see, Sheriff, I told you there had to be a different reason.
You did it that, Ricky. And I'm apologizing, son. Time we left, Parker.
I sure thank you for looking after my son, Mr. North.
You got a fine boy, Parker. You can be proud of him.
I am.
I ain't been much of a father to you, Les. But when I get out, and if you're willing, I'll do my best to make a home for you.
I'd sure like that, Pa.
You'll most likely find him over at my place, Parker. I've got plenty of room for a boy like you, Les. Let's go.
From a bow, like a mighty cannonball, he seems to fly. You'll hear about him everywhere you go.